She'll see you at once.
They're sick people, not criminals.
We've gone beyond that question, Your Majesty. They're
my citizens, and we will save them from the plague if we can. All of them.
Very well.
We will not speak of this again.
Mother, Corvo is back.
Thank you, Emily. Leave us, please.
As you wish, Your Majesty. Corvo, 2 days early, full of surprises, as usual.
It's a fair wind that brings you home to me. What news have you brought? I hope that one of the other cities had dealt with this before, knew of some cure. Corvo, thank you. If you hadn't been here...
No more! Not again!
Mommy!
No! Get away from her! Corvo!
Mommy! Get away! Corvo!
Corvo... It's all coming apart. Fine... Find Emily. Protect her. You're the only one. You'll know what to do. Won't you? Corvo.
Ward us all. Look at what he's done.
Yes, he's killed the Empress. What did you do with young Lady Emily, traitor?
Her own bodyguard. Ironic.
I'll see you beheaded for this, Corvo. Peg him.
Should eat, Corvo. This meal comes from a friend.
Another night, another patrol with you. Watch for booby traps. Could be some down here by the look of it.
Good. If we're lucky, one of them will get Corvo.
You're afraid of him? He's Sir Conan.
Sunwall citizen, the assassin Corvo, responsible for the murder of our fair empress and the disappearance of Lady Emily.
Over here. I'm Samuel, and I work for some good people who want very much to meet you. Well, they said you'd come out here. I can still hardly believe it. I'll take you to meet them. Just down the river from here.
This is the Hound Pit's pub, closed for business. Half the district marked off is dead from the plague. We're right under the Lord Regent's nose, and he don't know a thing. Of course, if anyone finds out what we're up to, the watch will break in with swords drawn. And now that you've escaped, the Lord Regent's going to be tearing the city apart. Take you up to meet Admiral Havelock and the rest of the Loyalists. The Admiral's a man to be reckoned with. If anyone can help you find that missing girl, Lady Emily, and clear your name, he can.
So it's starting at last.
We can continue this later, Lord.
Yes.
Piero's as much an artist as a technician.
Can you get a new tank from upstairs, please, while I hold this in place and be careful?
What can I do for you?
Death is inevitable.
If you like.
Well, let's get another thing.
Campbell is
ready to go. Just give the signal.
Go straight up Clavering Boulevard, but now it's not so easy. Half the city's dead of the plague. The other half's fighting over what's left. The City Watch still holds the bigger streets, and they've set up those wall of light checkpoints. A man walks through one of those, and he ends up burned to a crisp. Everything not controlled by the City Watch is gang territory. There are the real odd birds living on the fringes, like that Granny Rags. They say she's nuts. Which is worse. Just take your pick. hear it. Campbell lived a pretty posh life. Maybe it's not my place to say, but men of the faith shouldn't live like barons. You ready to go?
Okay, let's go.
Attention, all citizens living on the north side.
Corvo.
Take you to the Golden Cat when you're ready. I've taken Lord Pendleton enough times, believe me. I'll get you as close as I can to the Golden Cat, Corvo. You might have to go the rest of the way on your own. The entrance is near Holger Square. The main thing is to make sure that little girl, Emily, gets back all safe and sure. Them two Pendletons are there, so I'm guessing there'll be a lot of guards. Slackjaw might have some ideas on how to get inside the cat, if he don't kill you. This here's his territory. He and his Bottle Street gang hole up at the old Dunwall Whiskey Factory. They sell the elixir that folks use to fight off the plague. I'll lay low, but keep an eye out for you and the little lady you're bringing back. Good luck to you. I know Emily must mean a lot to you.
Who do you want me to be tonight? I'm sure we're... This place is on the river, so you must have come by boat. I'll wait.
Come on. Come to dinner now.
Ready to go?
Corvo, you must have worked wonders out there in the city tonight. I can't believe my old eyes. So you did the business, did you, Corvo? I'm not one. to speak against my betters, mind you, but if anybody ever deserved their fate, it was those Pendletons.
What business are you talking about?
Grown-up business, girl. I mean, your ladyship. Forgive me.
It's okay. I heard a lot of grown-up business at the Golden Cat.
Oh. I should concentrate on piloting this boat.
Young Lady Emily, I'm Callista. I'll be caring for you and schooling you while you're with us.
Pleased to meet you.
As am I. Would you like to see your room in the tower?
Can I see it?
Yes, you may. You'll get to see it all. The entirety of the Hound Pits.
Good. I think I'll like it here. I'll go with Callista, Corvo. I'll see you later.
You do not fail to impress. Armed with a blade, you've changed the course of the city forever. And with the Pendleton twins gone, our own Lord Pendleton will assume their votes in Parliament. In one night, you've done more than most men do in a lifetime. I need to speak to you soon. But for now, Lord Pendleton requests your attention.
Corvo, the loyal...
All right, my friend.
Very faint or something,
Josh. Off to Caldwin's Bridge, sir.
We'll get our sleep later. Just climb aboard when you're ready.
What do you think, Lobo? Caldwin Bridge. You've been in the city for years, but you lived in Dunwall Tower with the late Empress, so maybe you haven't visited the bridge before tonight. Something to look out for. See all them lights on the water? That's right, we'll be spotted for sure. You're gonna have to shut off your power before I can pick you up. Now, about bringing Sokolov back alive, he's smart. Maybe even smarter than Piero. Got the whole Dunwall under his thumb with all that natural philosophy business. New technology, potions and the like. Seems dangerous to me, but what do I know?
Set up the cell for Sokolov in the old kennel. Shackles and everything. It'll be a shock, him waking up in the straw and old dog poop. But from what I hear, he's woken up worse places. Guess we all have at that.
Hey,
your room while Callista was taking her bath. She told me if there's ever trouble, I should always run.
Attention, Doctor. Royal,
you're part of this rabble.
I hear you're off. You'll know.
The Boyle costume ball, huh? Well, that'll be fun, but not for everybody. You ready?
Yourself, Corvo.
They don't fool around. Good news is, once you get to the party, that mask of yours lets you blend right in. Enjoy your evening out with the folk of quality. Better you than me.
Enjoyed your evening, sir. But we'd best be on our way. Quickly.
Lord Pendleton said he would meet us here. I checked the wine cellar. Losing family gets a man a thirst.
You did it.
And now we've done away with a woman, and a noble woman at that. But Boyle was a viper. She helped the Lord Regent kill the Empress, so I don't feel a thing for her. You've had a long night, Corvo, but I fear it's not over. Havelock and Martin have already cooked up something more for you. They would like to see you now, in Havelock's chambers above the ball. Corvo.
Attention, Dunwall citizens.
Ready to face the Lord Regent?
About time we took care of my say. Long past time. Oh my. This is it, Corvo. The last memories of Dunwall Tower might not be good ones, huh? So maybe you can make up for what happened back then. A bit of a climb from the water log. The most important thing is killing the Lord Regent. Built himself quite a place at the top of the tower. Calls it his safe room or something. Crazy if you ask me. Another point of interest while I'm giving you the grand tour, Corvo. Broadcast control station here where all them announcements come from. Might be worth looking into. Next time I see you, the Lord Regent will be dead. And if not, well, it was an honor to serve with you.
for the Hound Pits. Thanks to you, Corvo. All right, let's go. Big changes. Makes me uneasy, to tell the truth. A small fry like me always gets the worst of it. But maybe it's going to be different now. Lord Regent is gone. The Abbey has a new High Overseer. I'm guessing our work is almost done. The others are in the bar. No doubt waiting to raise a glass in your name. Me, I think I'll just linger out here if you don't mind. Reflect on things while we have a moment. Congratulations, Corvo.
To Corvo.
No longer in house, his corrupt and sinful regime has come to a close. Long live the Emperor.
Samuel, you move like you've been.
This is the one who was with the Empress when she died. Poison. Tivian stuff.
Amateur work. He'll live.
That's up to Dowd.
Gift from your friend. The one who talks to you in the dark. Talks to you when you visit his shrines. I visited those shrines too. And I know what it felt like to shove a blade into your Empress. But I don't know you. Who you are, and who you fight for. You're a mystery. And I can't allow that.
Here you are.
Thank you.
alive. They killed everyone.
Then it's one more trip across the river. This is it, sir. I suspect Havelock Martin and Lord Pendleton landed there a while ago and went into the lighthouse. Knowing them, they're not giving up without a fight. I remember hearing the Admiral and Martin about this place is where they'd hold up if they had to. Anybody going in has to breach the fort and the gatehouse, and there's only one way to the top. All I can say is that it's been a pleasure serving with you. Maybe after all this is settled, we'll see each other again. Good luck, Corvo. If anyone deserves it, you do. Give my best to Emma.
Think I'd fight you?
Corvo! I knew you'd come. Is it going to be okay now? Will I be Empress?
So ends the interregnum, and now Emily Caldwin the First.